hour.
Now we are back live at the Olympic swimming pool and ready for the final of the men's 100 meter butterfly. The Olympic record in the event was established earlier today by Pablo Morales in qualifying. Morales, also the world record holder, a record he set at the United States Olympic trials a month ago. The story of how he started swimming is an interesting one. He told it earlier to Donna De Verona.
Pablo, how did you get involved in the sport of swimming?
It's a story I like to tell. It's a story that goes back to the days of my mom in Cuba when she was a little girl. She was swimming in the ocean with some friends, or she was on a raft, actually, and she wasn't a very good swimmer. In fact, I don't think she even knew how to swim. And somewhere or another, the raft tipped, and she was in the water. And she couldn't swim, obviously. She was thrashing about, and she thought she was going to die. But she doesn't, to this day, she says she doesn't know how she made it to the shore, but she made it. And she vowed from that day on that if she ever had kids, that they would learn to swim. And it's a story I like to tell, but it's true.
As you gather from that narrative, Morales is the son of Cuban immigrant parents. He has asked me not to use the word refugee to describe him, and I am more than happy to honor that request. So Morales will be swimming in lane four in the middle of the pool, and Mark Spitz, what's fascinating about this is the fact that he will be swimming directly next to Mikhail Gross of the Federal Republic of Germany, and that will be one heck of a battle to watch. Now let's look at all eight lanes. In lane one, Anthony Moss, 19 years old from New Zealand, doesn't figure to challenge here, although he's one of the better young 200-meter butterflyers in the world, and we may see him in medal contention in that race. Lane two, Bent Baron of Finspång, Sweden, best known as the 1980 Olympic gold medalist in the 100-meter backstroke. He's a graduate of the University of California. Lane three, Rafael Vidal, 20 years old from Venezuela, a member of the NCAA championship swimming team at the University of Florida. He won the bronze medal in last year's Pan American Games in this event, but is probably better at 200 meters. Lane four, Morales. He came into this year with his primary challenger for supremacy among American butterflyers being Matt Gribble, who held the world record at that time. Gribble did not make it to the final, bothered by a bad back, so Morales now stands alone as the top American butterfly sprinter. Lane five, Mikhail Gross. Last night you saw him lower his own world record in the 200-meter freestyle. He is also the world record holder in the 200-meter butterfly, and he is certainly a threat to whip Morales for the gold medal here. It is said by some that American swimmers, and indeed others, are intimidated by Gross's size. He's more than 6 feet 7 inches tall. We'll see if it bothers Morales. Lane six, Andrew Jameson, 19 years old from Great Britain, better known as a backstroker until the last few months. Lane seven, Glenn Buchanan, 21 years old from Australia, ranked only 16th in the world last year in this event, but he's the Australian national record holder, and the swimmers of that nation have been swimming very impressively here in the 2 days of Olympic competition so far. And in lane eight, Andreas Behrend from the Federal Republic of Germany is a distant second to Mikhail Gross among all West German butterfly swimmers. So those are the eight swimmers. Quite obviously, what you expect is the confrontation we have been talking about all along. There are the numbers on Morales. 53.78 is the Olympic record from qualifying this morning. The world record is 53.38. And Mark Spitz, Morales against Gross.
I think Pablo's thinking what it's going to take to win this race. And I really think that he's thinking that it's going to take a world record. But it's very difficult for him to concentrate on breaking a world record. He's got to stick with his game plan, thinking about his stroke, thinking about everything that he's learned over the last couple of years, especially the feeling that he had the last time he broke the world record.
As you looked at the two of them there, of course, it was Morales on the left and Gross on the right. Much is made. It is worth noting that the lane ropes are 8 feet, 2.5 inches apart. So if he were to spread his arms all the way out, he could almost touch both ropes. And Gross has gotten off to a good start and taken the lead early.
In the prelims, Pablo Morales had a faster time at the 50-meter mark by 21/100 of a second. And the starter gave a very fast and quick start here. And it may have caught Morales on the blocks a little bit. Now, Morales has used up about the last 20 meters of this first 50 meters to try to catch Gross. Now, Morales came out of the turn first. He's really going well right now.
What a remarkable turn. They're on the world record pace. Pablo Morales is in command if he can hold on. Here comes Gross. They are only inches apart in the middle of the pool, and Morales can feel every one of Gross's strokes. 20 meters to go. Mark, who do you like?
Morales has moved over to the right side of the lane. This may cost him a little bit of time. He's being miffed by
Gross is past him. Gross is going to touch him first. Absolutely. Mikhail Gross in a time of 53.08.
A new world record
has beaten world record holder Pablo Morales. And Morales also swam under his previous world record, but it wasn't enough. Second gold medal for the Albatross.
I'm telling you, I think that Pablo made a mistake in the last 10 meters. He moved over to the right side. He thought that he could draft. It's a technique used in training, and it cost him a little bit of rhythm in his stroke. You can see how disappointed he is, yet he broke the world record. Here we can see on the super slow-mo, Gross actually moved away from him, a smart move. Gross moved to his right because he was being crowded because of his long arm span coming down to the finish. These red lane lines indicate that they only have 5 meters to go, and at that one point, it appeared that Morales was ahead.
They are similar in age as you look at the finish. Gross is 20, Morales is 19, but there is a much wider gap than that in international experience. Gross has been to many more big international meets than Morales, and that may have been the difference there. As an apparent tactical error, according to Mark Spitz,
ladies and gentlemen, the board is now
cost
official.
Pablo Morales a chance to stay with Mikhail Gross as they came down to the wall. Now we'll be returning to our Olympic coverage, and of course we'll have more as the evening goes on from here at the pool after this word from our local stations.